what I've heard and seen saddens me immensely, as it should sadden and disturb every Indian. I mentioned in the morning in a condolence meeting that the state of Kerala and its people have a huge potential, and therefore the state needs peace. It deserves a peaceful environment. It deserves civility. It deserves democracy at its very best. We can understand, though never condone, any aberration as an exception. We can condemn it, we can call it unfortunate, we can punish the culprits. But when it becomes a series of incidents, it vitiates the environment of a state. In an environment of violence, people suffer, economy suffers, investment suffers, and obviously the atmosphere of democracy suffers. And it's sad that though it's a clear fact that every time the LDF is in power, the incidence of violence increase. You have political opponents being killed, and killed in the most brutal and barbaric manner. These are not incidents where there was some incident or a scuffle which was provocative and somebody accidentally died. You corner an innocent victim, you catch him when he's alone, and you inflict multiple wounds on his body. The kind of wounds inflicted on Rajesh would have even embarrassed the terrorists. That is the cruelty and enormity of the barbaric nature in which this violence has taken place. You have, in a series of these incidents, a large number of political workers being killed. Party offices have been attacked. Our president of the state unit got saved by a whisker. The police was a silent spectator. Houses of political workers and RSS swayamsevaks have been attacked. Injuries have been caused on a large number of them. At the end of the day, it's the responsibility of the state to ensure that the perpetrators of these crimes are brought to book. A deterrent punishment is imposed on them. The police is expected to be fair. And if these two things don't happen, this environment of violence won't end. I had come here really to express solidarity with the victims of this violence, and I would appeal to all political parties, more particularly the ruling party and the state government, that it is primarily their responsibility to take all necessary steps to ensure that this atmosphere ceases to exist. I reiterate once again that the state needs peace and it deserves peace. We in the BJP strongly stand with our workers and our state unit, and the central party would be supporting them in whichever manner. Our workers here are already have undertaken a campaign to support those families whose bread earners have been snatched away from them. I was told through the media that there was an argument being put up that there are some victims amongst the members of the left parties also. I have no difficulty. If anybody wants to meet me, I'll be too glad to meet them. It's our mutual responsibility in the political system to see that violence doesn't take place. But the kind of argument which is being propounded, which I have read in a section of the media, that there are victims on all sides, I think this fake equivalence which is sought to be brought between the perpetrators of crimes and the victims. If the argument is eventually to rely on this fake equivalence, I repeat, between the perpetrators and the victims, that attitude will not bring violence to an end. There can't be in this country double standards on incidents of this kind. Let us assume the kind of violence which has taken place recently, or the political violence in Kerala, had taken place in any BJP or NDA ruled state. What would have happened? Awards would have been returned. Editorials would have been written. Parliament would not have been allowed to function. And campaigns would have been carried within and outside this country. And those who would have done it are today most eloquent in their silence. And some of them are trying to bring about this immoral equivalence between the perpetrators of violence and the victims Can there ever be an argument in a civilized society that there is violence on all sides or that there are victims on all sides? Does that justify an atmosphere of this kind? And therefore, what is needed now is fairness and neutrality, efficiency by the state police. What is needed is a political will and determination by the state government to discipline its own cadres, rather than let them lose on political opponents. I do hope and pray that this environment doesn't continue for very long. Both our central and state party would like to fully cooperate in putting an end to this atmosphere of violence, and I do hope the state government takes active steps to prevent the recurrence of any such incident. Thank you. But I think that's the truth. Why is it that when the LDF is in power, this atmosphere of violence increases? Sir. And at the end of the day, if you have an effective policing by the state, if you have fairness by the police, that irrespective of who commits the offence, immediate actions are taken, such recurrence will not take place.
So do you think the state government has utterly failed in containing the violence, at least in the last 1 year, because there has been nearly 14 incidents?
Well, I have used whatever I wanted to say. I've said it in my own language. I think what I've said, the message is loud and clear. Pardon?
After meeting so many victims and all, do you think?
Well, there are statements which have been made by different people, but I have said what I wanted to say. Well, madam, is violence versus violence an explanation? Can a state government or a ruling party ever say that since there is are multiple incidents of violence taking place on all sides, so that's a condemnation of my own conduct? And those friends, even in the media, who are lending credence to these theories, must seriously introspect that a single incident in another state, it's condemnable. But is there reportage and rationale for this violence on the same standard as to how they dealt with the others?
Sir, do you at least agree that RSS in the state is also a part of this violence?
Well, I don't agree with that.
But the statistics.
If you see the numbers, in the last few months, ever since this government has returned to power, you can see the extent to which our workers have been victims. Well, I am absolutely prepared to meet anybody who wants to meet me.
So they have written a letter to you. So
well, I have not received any such letter. If it has been sent to my office, I am here. I am not know. But notwithstanding that technical formality, if anybody wants to meet me, he is welcome to meet me. It's my responsibility to meet people. It's my duty. And therefore, I have no difficulty in meeting anyone.
Sir, the all-party meetings are being organized here. So peace talks are happening. Do you think they will? They are trying to whip up passion
well,
between
I think,
parties?
Well, I think holding such meetings is a positive step. And I do hope something positive does come out of the environment that it generates.
Sir, will you be taking this up with Mr. Narendra Modi when you go back? Will you be talking to him? Is there anything that we can expect from the, for the state? A peaceful?
Well, we in politics do discuss all this within the government, within the party. We also discuss it with the political opponents. It's not that this is a...
Sir, to be specific, in writing report rather than just a discussion.
No. I have no intention of submitting in writing report. I have not come for that purpose. Purpose of my visit is to meet the victims.
So the timing of the visit comes the day when
the more party. No, it's not. The two are interrelated. I have already said that I do hope that any effort which is directed in the direction of bringing peace to the state is necessary. Ultimately, political parties and their leaders must meet each other and try and put their heads together and find a solution. Well, merely because peace talk is being held, you want to take away my party's right to express its anguish and pain also. Well, does that justify? Well, the fact that... Well, it's very unfortunate and sad if that anybody has been killed in the state. But the fact is that that doesn't justify an environment of violence. We are not living in an anarchic situation. We are living in a democratic situation.
CPI-M says that they are the victims basically of... CPI-M says that they are the victims of RSS BJP terror, and they quote statistics to show right from 91 or 2000. So how would you react to that? Because on both sides, people are dying. Will you tell
Well, let us now see what the current situation in the last few months has been that they've been in power.
There has been deaths on the CPM side also.
Well, that doesn't justify the environment of violence. As I've already said, that this kind of equivalence, is this in a civilized society any rationale or justification of the presence of violence? Ultimately, the responsibility is of a state government. The responsibility is of the ruling party to correct the environment in a state. The buck stops with the ruling party.
But there are BJP RSS workers involved in crimes like this. So what
well, if anybody is involved in a crime, please take appropriate action. You can't have party offices being attacked and the security cameras capturing police as a silent spectator. It's only when the police becomes a spectator and a participant in this activity that the control and the moral authority of the state to control then gets reduced.
Will you also be appealing to your workers on this?
I am appealing to all the people, including my workers, the workers of all political parties. It's our duty to do, make sure that there is peace in the state. I'm from a?
Military. I'm from Kannur. Ethnic center of violence. From my childhood, it's a fire scene, many murders, and I can show you, at least, 500 to 600 living vegetables there in Talisheri and Panur areas. So, every time, there will be a customary peace meeting, and again, violence starts. This has been going on for many years.
Well, I think there is political opposition between parties in almost every state in the country. But this kind of an environment where people mutually, physically attack each other doesn't happen. It's only very rarely that such incidents happen. They can't happen as a pattern. I think it's for all of us to put our heads together and think about it.
So 2 months back, there were two people killed from the minority community. One was a Muslim cleric and one was someone who is converted into Muslim. And they don't have any political inclination also. The culprits behind were RSS also, it seems.
Well, I don't think the political affiliation of a culprit or the religion of the culprit is any defense. If somebody has committed a crime, it's the duty of the police to take action against them. But then one only expects the police to be fair. That's all I'm saying.
For the last couple of days, the BJP members in the parliament are saying that CPI-M in Kerala are trying to restrict their political workers of RSS and BJP. Is that the biggest threat the BJP is facing in Kerala?
Well, I don't think these incidents can ever form a threat to the existence of a political party. These acts don't reduce or narrow down the base of a political party. If at all, it can only help it to grow. This has never happened in politics.
So we would like to hear your comments on this. There are certain state BJP leaders, it's heard that they had demanded, bribe for getting license for medical colleges in Kerala, like that. And we would like to hear your comments on that.
Well, we are the only political party which is a part of self-introspection, took action against them. I compliment the state president for the action he took.
Yes, actions were
well. You have examples in several states where people have been caught in improprieties and parties strongly trying to defend them. I think if a party sets a precedent by throwing its member out on an alleged suspicion, it's a good stand it's a good step in Indian politics.
Yes, obviously it's a good stand and we do agree that, but sir, what we are asking is that actions were taken against local leaders, or certain allegations were pointed against the state leaders, and we would like to know the central's comment on these type of allegations that
no, the state think, leaders I are think facing. The state leadership, we have full confidence in them, they can take care of it.
Even the report prepared by the inquiry commission, which the BJP itself made, are pointing that bribe were taken by some state leaders' name were mentioned in the report.
Well, I think, as I have said, we have full faith in our state leaders. They will take appropriate action as they already have in these cases. Thank you.
Last Sunday, the Kerala governor had summoned the chief minister. And people came to know about bullying after the governor had put out in his Twitter handle. Many people are asking, does this happen in other BJP rural states where violence takes place?
Well, I think the role of the president and the role of the governor has been clearly defined. He has to ensure that governance carries on accounts in accordance with the constitution. It's his job to ensure that, and it's his job to advise whenever he thinks that such advice is needed. It's also his job to send periodic, it's his responsibility to send periodic reports to the president. And I don't think when a governor does this, it's fair for anybody to really comment on the conduct of the governor. That's a very fair conduct. On the contrary, if a governor was merely a mute spectator, he would be failing to discharge his duty.
Sir, Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan has deliberately avoided taking up responsibility on any of the attacks that happened in the state and recent the Rajesh's death. Right now, you have also deliberately avoided. Are you deliberately avoiding any sort of responsibility of the other retaliation that you have from your party, from the party members?
No, I am not taking or not taking any responsibility. I am concerned really with the kind of environment in the state, and therefore I have made what I think is the most appropriate statement under the circumstances.
So in that case, are you providing grants and aids to the people who have been affected by this?
Yes, my party has undertaken a a campaign to really provide relief and look after the families which have been seriously and adversely impacted by this violence.
So, family of both the sides or just BJP, whoever affected by the CPM?
No, my party is looking after its own workers.
Sir,
thank you.
Sir, the state-run Chinese media, Global Times, have accused the Modi government of recklessly pushing New Delhi into war by introducing hardline tactics towards China.
Well, already the External Affairs Minister has already spoken at length in Parliament. I don't want to add anything more to her statement.
Sir, there has been several incidents. Sir, there have been several incidents where all party meetings and peace talks have happened, but post that there have been retaliation and attacks. So, if this happens again, in spite of having peace talks, do you think what
will be the
strongest
intervention?
Why should I comment?
Let me hope that these don't happen. I can't make a comment on the premise that this will happen again. Why should I do that?
Sir, but do you think that the CPM or the government is only responsible for whatever violence that is happening in this?
Well, state? I think it's the prime responsibility of the ruling government always to create an adequate environment. There are political cadres which feel emboldened when in power. And that is why when the LDF is in power, these incidents have traditionally increased. Thank you.
One question, sir, to the finance minister. So it's 1 month since GST has been introduced. And what is the term of feedback you have?
Well, it's been an extremely smooth turnover without any disruption. Thank you. That's not correct. Record number of registrations have taken place and the registrations have been very, very smooth.